So today we're sitting down with Whitley Strieber, and he has written over 30 books, maybe even 40. It's hard to keep track, but today we're going to do a retrospective series about the Afterlife Revolution. And this is a book that Whitley wrote in 2020. And can you explain to us your inspiration behind this book?
Yeah, well, I started writing the book in 2015, right after my wife passed away, because some extraordinarily strange things began to happen almost immediately. I began to get calls from friends saying that they just heard Anne's voice telling them to call me. And this would happen when I was thinking about her and feeling the grief very intensely. And I finally remembered that Anne and I had made a pact back in the 1990s when we discovered that this whole close encounter thing is connected somehow to the dead. And we began to feel that we do persist after death. And so our pact was that the first one to pass away would contact friends, if it was possible to contact anyone. Mm-hmm. Not directly, because neither one of us would have believed that. And after this happened over about a two-week period with numerous people spread around the country, I remembered the pact, and I thought, it's Anne. I went to a conference, and I have cameras all over this apartment and have had for a long time in hopes of catching some historic footage, which has not happened yet. In any case, this strangest thing happened at one of the conferences. I kept getting texts from the camera saying that there was movement. And when I looked, there was a moth, a white moth, flying back and forth in front of the camera, just back and forth, right there, not going anywhere. And that happened quite a few times. And someone said to me, that doesn't look like an ordinary moth. And then I remembered Anne had asked me the January before she passed on to start memorizing a poem called Song of the Wandering Angus by W.B. Yeats. And I wondered, why does she want me to do this? At the time, I wasn't expecting her to pass away. I was trying to keep her alive. So I memorized the poem. And now this came back to me, that the poem has the line in it, when white moths were on the wing and the moth-like stars were flickering out. And I thought, white moths? A white moth in the camera? And then I remembered Anne's favorite short story of mine is called The White Moths. And I thought, she's created an avatar. That is the symbol of Anne. That means Anne is present. And it became a huge part of my life. I was up at the Esalen Institute up in Northern California presenting about Anne and the Afterlife Revolution, which we more or less wrote together after she died, because once I was in contact with her, it was quite easy. Mm-hmm. But I was there talking about it, and after my talk, a white moth, this was in February, a white moth appeared over a dining table and flew around everybody. And it was quite amazing because, you know, the white moths are not common in February. And then we had a big banquet at the end of this conference. Many people had presented. And in the middle of the banquet, a white moth appeared and began flying around in circles in front of everyone. Everyone was laughing and applauding because they all knew the story of the white moth. Whereupon, it proceeds to land on the head of Jeremy Vaney, a podcaster who used to podcast on unknowncountry.com, and Anne just loved his podcasts. And I took a picture of the white moth on Jeremy Vaney's head. Then it went up, flew off, and right before our eyes, just suddenly wasn't there anymore. And I thought to myself, that's Anne's avatar. That means she's present and conscious and really here. You know, one of the first things Anne said after I realized I was in contact with her was really very telling. she said, "It looks like you're all intentionally ignoring us."
Yeah.
And she said also, and this was very telling, "I'm not Anne anymore, I'm me, but I'll always be Anne for you." And she is.
That's so sweet.
If you want to listen to the Afterlife Revolution, check the link in my bio and sign up for a free trial at audible.com.